guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Olowilara, and today I'll be talking about my experience with housemaids. Many people have different experiences with housemaids, either favorable or unfavorable. Today I'll tell you my own personal experience with housemaids and what made up my mind never to make use of housemaid again. I have actually made use of many of them, but I would like to talk about just four of the housemaid that I've made use of. The first one, I did not employ her as a housemaid per se. Then I was working and I was having a shop where I sell things. So as I then I was looking for a sales girl, and she came around. So after I interviewed her, I found her okay, but the problem there was that she stayed too far away from where the shop was located. There was no way she can be coming all the way from her house to the shop every day, because she will spend more than her salary coming to the shop. So I asked her if she would like to stay at my place and be going home every weekend. So she agreed. So I follow her to her house to know her parents, to know where she came from, because I believe it's not that ideal to just put somebody in your house without knowing where the person came from or something. So I follow her to her place. I met her parents. I saw all of them and the siblings, and at least we were okay. And so that's how she started. So when this girl came, she will sleep from night to morning. In the morning, she will not get up. She will stay in bed. I'll wake up in the morning, prepare the children for school, cook and everything before this girl will eventually get up. That wasn't even my problem, because I did not employ her as a maid. But she's somebody that I took like a younger sister. And if you could be staying in my house, you have your own room to yourself, you have your personal toilet and bath, you eat in the morning, afternoon, and at night. You also need some other basic things that you will need personally that I was also providing. So what does it take? Even if you sweep, wash plate, or do some other small chores in the house, I don't see any big deal in that. But she just decided not to do anything, and I left her alone. Anytime she feel like doing, I'll leave her to do. If she did not do, I'll just leave her alone. But where the problem started from was that she started packing the money in the shop. She'll go to the shop in the morning, come back in the evening. She'll come back with the sales record. She'll record half of what she has sold for the day. She'll keep half of the money to herself. And by weekend, she'll go home with the money. She has actually worked for like 3 to 4 months before I decided to do stock taking. Because as a career person, you go to work in the morning, you come back in the evening, Monday to Friday. The weekend, you want to have it to yourself to relax, to take care of the home and some other things. So the time was not really there. And then I was thinking she was a good girl. So at the end of like 3 months or 4, I decided to do the stock. And when we did the stock taking, we have a shortage of 100,000 plus. And when I asked her, what happened? Is that you sold on credit, or you give the money to somebody's girl? She will not answer. She will just be looking at you like this. Ask questions from today to tomorrow. She will not answer you. I don't know where she got that kind of strategy from. You'll be asking her, where's the money? Do you give it to anybody? Do you spend it? She will just be looking at you, she will not answer. I got so fed up and I said, okay, if that is the case, and you cannot just explain what happened to the money, then just leave now. So we're going home that particular day, and I didn't know how she managed to call her mom. Before I got to, my mom called me, she said her money was not complete, this and that. She know her daughter very well. She doesn't steal. She doesn't do this. But at the same time, she would not like me to send her away, because everybody in their environment knew that she's already working. And if they see her again, this and that I should just allow her to be working. That instead of sending her away, I should be taking her salary to complete the money or something. And I left the girl. She worked for another 3 months and I did not pay her any salary. But the thing is that she was still packing the money. So it got to a state that I said, no, enough is enough, please. And that's how I sent her away. Then I employed another one. This one, in fact, she's very dead. As in, I don't know what kind of word to use to qualify her. If you are talking about dirtiness, come and look for this girl. She find it difficult to bait. If you ask her to go and bait, she'll enter the bait. She'll stay there for like 15 minutes and she'll come out without baiting. And she'll dress up. If you stay with this girl for 5 minutes and there's no fun, that is blowing away the odor. The kind of odor and smell that will be oozing out of this girl's body, will not be able to stand it. As in, she's very dirty and even she could not even do anything. Even her own food, she could not make food for herself. I'll still be the one that will be doing her food for her and everything. So there was a particular that was going out. I told her, sweep the house, arrange the house, wash your toilet and everything. I went out in the morning, I came back, and everything was just weird. I left it. Then this girl is also fond of sleeping. She will sleep in her room. She will sleep naked and she will leave the door open. As at then, she was like maybe 16 to 17 years old. The very busty girl. She will sleep like this without wearing anything. The first time I saw her, I said, what is your problem? Why is your door open? I'm not concerned about you opening your body. You can open your body as long as you want it, but make sure that your door is locked. So I left her alone. The other time, even after I've cautioned her, she did the same thing. She slept, opening all her body, her breast and everything. And my children will be there. If they pass our room, they will see her naked like that. If my husband passed, he will see him as well. See her rather. So, and I've cautioned her, and she did not want to listen. So it got to say that I got fed up. This girl, she doesn't know money. If you ask her to go and buy something, she doesn't know the amount of change she will collect. She doesn't know anything. So it got to say that I could not even manage her. I have to return her. Even this one, the one that I even paid, I've not even exhausted when I returned her. I have to get a refund of the money that I paid. And that's how she left. Then I got another one. This particular girl, the parents, I went to Badagry to go and pick her. A relative actually took me to her parents and he said they don't need money, they don't need anything. All they want was just to put their girl in school. They want her to be educated. And so I said, okay, if that's what you want, there's no problem. She will go to school. And I took her home, took her to my children's school. They actually have the primary and the secondary session. So when she got there, they said they will have to do a kind of test or examination for her before they know the class that she'll go. Meanwhile, she was in just where she was coming from. Okay, when they gave her dictation, they were calling something like bag, school, book, pencil. No ambiguity, this girl could not write. And they were like, you said this girl, I said, she's in JS2. They said, no, that they cannot put her in secondary, that they will put her in primary. That if not because of her age, that they're supposed to put her in primary one, and because of her age, 17-year-old girl, that they put her in primary four. So that's how they put her in primary four. So they said, if she catches up, then maybe they'll ask her to write common interest. And so, just 6 days after this girl came, I've gone to work. She was doing there with the children. And she called my children and told them that she will soon be leaving. And my daughter was like, you just came. Why will you leave so soon? She now said that I forgot to say that I was pregnant when this girl came. So I was close to delivery, like 7 months plus. So she now said, you know that your mom is pregnant and she will soon be going to the hospital to deliver a baby. And when she goes, she will not come back. And the baby will not come back. And your family will come and pick your children. And there will not be anybody in the house again. So what will she now be doing? So when I go home, my daughter called me and said, I should hear what this girl said. And I said, I now called her that. Is it true that you said this? She said, yes, that she said. I said, where do you go down from? I said, she did not answer. Is it, do you see it in a dream? She did not answer. Did anybody tell you She knows that, she said she did not know that all, that's all she knew, that if I go to hospital to deliver, I will not come back and the baby will not come back. I was shivering like this because I've never had that kind of thing, that you will confront the person and be telling the person that you will die. And it's just been like 2 months for me to, less than 2 months for me to deliver. And somebody was telling me that I will not come back. When I asked her, she could not tell me where she got the revelation from. That very night, I go home around 6 o'clock and I asked her to pack her things. That's how we went back to Badagry, where I picked her from. We got to Badagry around 12 midnight. So I took her to the lady from whom I got the link to her parents. And I said, see your girl, and he gave me, this is what she said. So I passed the night there, and the following morning I came back to my place. And that's how the battle started. I was praying every night. Once I get to bed, I'll just be praying. I'll be praying, giving myself in the blood of Jesus, doing all sorts of things. I went for deliverance. I was going for prayers here and there. I was on leave. I was just going for prayers. That God, just take control. Just take control. Our confession will not come to pass over my life. I was just prophesying different kind of things to myself, to my unborn baby. So the day of the delivery came. Actually, I was not having contraction, and it was the same thing with the last baby that I had. There was no contraction, so I was not surprised when this one was like that too. So I was given a date. I was scheduled for induction on a particular day like that, and that's how I packed my things and I went to hospital. And after the whole process, I back up and everything. Even when I got to the hospital, I was checked. You know, all these normal pregnancy checkup, blood, urine, weight, BP, and everything. And the baby was checked, and everything was normal. So, lo and behold, the baby came out dead. As in, the baby actually died. Without no reason. And I was like, even the video would say, this thing just happened, this thing just, they did all their food, they tried all their best, but the baby did not make it. I believe she wasn't responsible for the death of the baby, because she does not have power. I do not even believe that she has power to kill either me or the baby. But later, I'll tell you what caused the death of the baby. That's how the baby actually died. And when I was going on, I was still with, as in I was checking that this girl said 2 things, that I will not come back and the baby will not come back. Now the baby is home, the baby is not coming back home. And now it remains me. And I was praying that God, take me home. Let nothing bad happen to me. Let no adverse happen on the way. Though the hospital is not that far from home. But I said, God, I just committed everything into process. To God in the glory, I'm still alive today. Then I got another one. After that one, I still got another one. And this one, a Tush girl. Very Tush. She's not a maid though. She was staying with her elder sister. Yeah, because her parents are based in the village. So she was staying with her elder sister. And I got to know that the sister's husband was like sexually harassing her or something. So they were looking for somewhere for her to stay. And that's how she got to my place. This girl, she'll be eating like this. She'll be eating, she'll be pressing her phone, and she'll be watching television at the same time. I'll be doing all sorts of house chores. She'll not even, she'll just be looking at me like this. She will watch movie from evening till midnight, like 2 a.m., 3 a.m. I'll be in my room and I'll still be hearing the voice of the voice from the television. She'll be watching. And by, let's say, 3 o'clock, she'll not go to bed. So she'll now start sleeping till morning. The children will be ready for school and everything. And she just finished our egg. The children will be ready for school and she'll still be there sleeping. And once she gets there, she'll just come to the kitchen to come and dish her food. So the time came and she called me that she will be traveling home for one exam or the other. And I said, as you are going, just carry the load of your bag and don't come back with you. She was so sad. But once I said this, there's no coming back. She called my husband on the phone. I think husband called me that one of us.